What does manipulating the native DOM in an Angular component mean? In the last few weeks, I was part of a review session about Angular RFC signals. During the discussion, we were asked the following question. How many of you have ever manipulated the native DOM in an Angular component? Though I have witnessed different cases of DOM manipulation during my years of experience with Angular, the question piqued my curiosity, and I found it an excellent subject for more in-depth exploration. In today's fast-paced world of web development, DOM manipulations play a steering role. Think of it as the secret sauce that brings dynamic and interactive web applications to life, captivating users with every click and scroll. But what's the key of a truly delightful user experience? You guessed it. Efficient DOM manipulation. As web applications evolve to become more sophisticated and packed with features, mastering the art of DOM manipulation is crucial. Not only does it help to maintain top-notch performance, but it also keeps resource users in check. Now, what makes Angular stand out in the crowd? It's the framework's clever way of handling the DOM. While some frameworks like jQuery rely on direct DOM manipulation, and other modern frameworks like React, Svelte, and Vue have their efficient ways of working with the DOM, Angular is all about embracing its built-in abstractions. These nifty tools provide a more maintainable, secure, and platform-independent approach of working with the DOM, making your web development journey a lot smoother. With this in mind, in this video, I will dive into what native DOM manipulation is all about, why it's essential to have it in our toolbox, and what approaches you can employ in an Angular app to work with the DOM. So open up your laptop, spin up your favorite code editor, and let's embark in this exciting adventure together. DOM versus native DOM manipulation. In the context of Angular, DOM manipulation and native DOM manipulation are terms used to describe different ways of interacting with the document object model in an Angular application. Here is a brief explanation of each. DOM manipulation. This refers to an Angular's built-in platform agnostic way of interacting with the DOM. Angular uses its own abstraction layer to manipulate the DOM, which means you don't have to deal with the native DOM API directly. Angular provides abstractions like the following one to work with the DOM to ensure consistency, security, and maintainability. Template syntax. Angular provides a powerful template syntax that allows you to bind component properties to DOM elements, handle user events, and control visibility and structure the DOM using directives. For example, you can use property binding, event binding, and structural directives like ng-if, ng-for to control the DOM. Renderer 2 is an Angular abstraction layer that allows you to manipulate the DOM in a platform-agnostic way. It makes your code more maintainable and compatible with different platforms, like web browsers, server-side rendering or SSR, or even non-DOM platforms like NativeScript. ElementRef. ElementRef is a wrapper around the native DOM element and provides a more controlled way to access and manipulate the DOM in your component. You can use ElementRef in combination with Renderer 2 to perform DOM manipulations without directly interacting with the native DOM APIs. ViewChild and ViewChildren. ViewChild and ViewChildren are Angular decorators that allow you to access and manipulate child elements and components within a parent component. You can use them in a combination with ElementRef and Renderer 2 to perform DOM manipulations. There are also content child, content children, and view container. By using Angular DOM manipulation, you can perform common tasks like adding, updating, or deleting elements, as well as applying styles and attributes. Angular's DOM manipulation is recommended because it makes your code more portable, maintainable, and less prone to errors. Here is an example. You can see how we are using renderer to set a style to an element that we are accessing with element ref. We are adding the CSS property background color with the value blue. Native DOM manipulation. To use the native DOM in an Angular component, you would bypass Angular's abstractions and interact with the DOM directly using vanilla JavaScript or TypeScript. For example, you might use DocumentGetElementById, DocumentQuerySelector, AppendChild, ElementClassList, or ElementAddEventListener. While native DOM manipulation can offer more control, it's generally not recommended in Angular applications because it can lead to less maintainable code and may introduce security vulnerabilities like XSS, cross-site scripting attacks. Here is an example of directly accessing the native DOM. To add the CSS property background color with the value blue to an element accessed with element ref. Why do developers need to manipulate the DOM? In Angular applications, developers manipulate the DOM to update the user interface, handle user interactions, and control the visual presentation of components dynamically. Although Angular's built-in abstractions like template syntax, renderer2, and element ref help manage the DOM, there are cases where direct DOM manipulation is necessary and more efficient. Here are some real-world scenarios where DOM manipulation may be required in an Angular app. Third-party library integration. When integrating with third-party libraries that were not designed specifically for Angular, you might need to use DOM manipulation to create, modify, or remove elements based on the requirements of the library. For example, when integrating with jQuery plugin or a library like D3JS for data visualization, you may need to interact with the DOM directly. Advanced UI effects and animations. Angular provides built-in support for animations, but in some cases, you might need more fine-grained control over animations or complex visual effects that require direct manipulation of the DOM, such as updating the style or attributes of elements in response to user interaction or changing data. Performance optimization. While Angular's built-in abstractions are suitable for most use cases, there might be performance-critical situations where direct DOM manipulation can lead to better performance. For example, in large tables with thousands of rows, using the native DOM API for update-specific cells can be faster than relying on Angular's change detection and rendering mechanism. Custom form control. When creating custom form controls that need to integrate with Angular's form system, you might need to manipulate the DOM directly to manage focus, input, or validation states. Case study. Logprep dissector process. Logprep is a tool that allows collecting, processing, and forwarding log messages from different data sources. Similar to the GROC processor, Logprep dissect processor also extract structured fields of a single text field within a document. As a case study, I have here an Angular component that allows the user to dissect log messages, then send the use dissect pattern to the REST API, which will run the Logprep processor. The user can choose some proposed fields that are automatically found by the application, or select a substring from the log message and use it as a value for a new field. Here are a few examples of dissecting log messages. In this first example, I am extracting oct as month from this log message, 17th as day of month, and the rest as time. And in this example, I am extracting the first part as .date and the rest as short time. because in the rest I can see the hour and minutes. From this third example, I am extracting date and time. And I have chosen T and dot as separator. Here is a more interesting example from which I will extract date, time, HTTP version, HTTP method, HTTP response, and file path. That's nice. Let's have a look now at what's happening under the hood in order to add background colors to the log messages on the top. So whenever the user chooses to extract a substring as a new field, the position of this substring in the original log message will be automatically determined. The substring will get a background color that depends on its order in the list of extracted fields. A new object of type dissected field will be created with that position, background color, the substring itself as a value, and the name entered by the user. This dissected field object will be added to an array, extracted fields. Then the extracted fields list will be passed and the background color of each of its elements will be added to the associated substring in the original log message. This will be done by the method addBGColorsToFields, which takes as parameters log message and extracted fields list. The method is using renderer2 of Angular to manipulate the string and add HTML properties to It. So basically, the original log message, which should be a string in the beginning, will be replaced with a new string that contains the span HTML tag with some tailwind CSS classes like pgAmber 300, pgGreen 300, pgBlue 300, rounded XL, padding, and so on. In order to render this HTML content correctly, I added the log message in the template as inner HTML, as you can see here. And I have initialized the variable log message with BG colors with the value of log message. That's nice. But what if I haven't used the Angular built-in approach to change the DOM and manipulated the native DOM directly? What would the source code look like? That's a great question. If I have used such a bad practice, my source code might be similar to the following one. Here I'm using document create element, document create text mode. Worse if I don't know how to use document create element, document create text node, class list add, outer HTML, I may implement the add BG colors to fields method as below. This approach is not recommended and can lead to security vulnerabilities such as cross-site scripting attacks, as well as other issues. So compared to other frameworks, Angular provides a comprehensive set of abstractions and tools for DOM manipulation, which makes it easier to write maintainable, secure, and platform-independent code. However, these abstractions may come with some trade-offs. Performance: while Angular's change detection and rendering mechanism are efficient in most cases, there could be situations where direct DOM manipulation is faster. For example, in large data-bound tables, using native DOM APIs might provide better performance. Learning curve. Angular's abstractions, such as template syntax, renderer2, may take some time to learn, especially for developers who are new to the framework or have experience with other libraries or frameworks that rely on direct DOM manipulation. Integration with third-party libraries. Integrating Angular with third-party libraries that rely on direct DOM manipulation can be more challenging compared to frameworks that don't have built-in abstractions for DOM manipulation. So whenever possible, use Angular's built-in abstractions, otherwise it's essential to be cautious about potential security risks and other issues.